Hey there, Heather. Ho there. It's Jeff Cutter Diamond. Welcome you to the semis and finals video for the Junior Welterweights Legends of Boxing Tournament. We have Aaron Pryor versus Ricky Hatton and Julio, Cesar Chavez against Eddie Perkins. So great semifinals abound. We are going to preview this match. This is Pryor versus Hatton. Pryor, 39-1 lifetime with 35 knockouts from Cincinnati against Manchester's Ricky the Hitman Hatton, 45-3 with 32 knockouts. Aaron's won by TKO unanimous decision and split points. And Hatton's won 2 by TKO and 1 by split decision, so I don't know what could happen.
Thank you.
feet, but hadn't kept getting knocked down. That's why he couldn't do it. And Pryor won the fight. Not a good match for Haddon, but what can you say? Now we got ourselves Julio Cesar Chavez against Eddie Perkins. Chavez has won all three matches by TKO, something that rarely is done. He's from Sonora, Mexico. Eddie Perkins, the hometown boy from Chicago, 74 wins, 2 by unanimous decision, 1 by majority points. So now he's got to face Chavez. He might win. We'll see.
Thank you.
So the final has Aaron Pryor and Eddie Perkins in it. In the red corner from Cincinnati, Ohio. He's 4-0 in the tournament, 2 wins by TKO, 1 by unanimous decision, 1 by split decision. His lifetime record was 39 wins, 1 loss with 35 KOs. Aaron the Hawk Pryor! And in the blue corner from Chicago, Illinois, lifetime record of 74-20-3 with 21 KOs. He's a junior welterweight as well. His record in this tournament, 4 wins, no losses, 3 by unanimous decision, 1 by majority. Eddie Perkins. So Pryor versus Perkins. How did these guys get in? Well, Pryor beat Johnny Bumpus by TKO in the first round. Perkins took care of Sal Mombi by unanimous decision. And then Pryor in round 16 took down Terry Marsh by unanimous decision. Eddie Perkins won by majority against Timothy Bradley, which was huge. Quarterfinals, Aaron Pryor beat Mickey Ward by split decision. Eddie Perkins would win by unanimous decision over Antonio Cervantes. And then you saw the semifinals, Pryor, TKO, Haddon, and Perkins taking down Chavez by unanimous decision. So, who's going to win? A few of these might say Pryor, but this is in Chicago after all.
Thank you.
Pryor is going to send Perkins flying. That those last few rounds may have saved Perkins a little bit, but Pryor is going to win. That's what they say. Let's see what the judges say.
Perkins.
Pryor. Perkins! So Perkins wins by split decision, and Aaron the Hot Pryor must be peeved off. Hometown favoritism, maybe? But yeah. Pryor was exactly the point he ran 11 for his fouls. So if you take the point and make it a 10-9 round for Pryor, well, 10-8 for Perkins in the 11th round. Well, the points would have went to Pryor, TKO points. Perkins didn't have any TKO, but the fouls, 6 points. Yeah, you add a point to Pryor, for both guys going 10-9. Pryor, it would have been a tie. The one judge, it would not have mattered, but it would have been 114-114 on the first judge card, on the first judge's card, meaning that it would have been a 1-1-1. We would have had to have a rematch. But in the end, Perkins wins in a shocker. If it wasn't for that foul by Pryor, I think for sure he would have forced a tie, and then we would have had to simulate the tie. But in the end, Eddie Perkins is your junior welterweight champion. And the results show for yourselves. You can't foul people and get away with it. You just can't. Anyway, I'm Jeff Diamond. I do.